Bonjour. Today's lesson is about directional prepositions, talking about where things are in space. And we're also going to have a bit of a review about possessive adjectives, saying my bed and our lamp and her couch, etc. So here we have a few words. These 12 words, I'm going to ask you to make some flashcards with them in class. So make sure that you record these down in your notes because I will not have a printout for you. So we have au-dessus de, au-dessous de, and we've talked about au-dessus and au-dessous. We just have a very small spell change here. Sur, sous, à côté de, à gauche de, à droite de, entre, derrière, au milieu de, devant, en face de. What we have in the next few slides are just some visual examples of how we're actually going to use these directional prepositions in sentences. Some of them are used in very similar ways and some of them are a little bit different. So it might help you to draw some quick pictures in your notes and write down a sentence that goes with each one, but I will leave that up to you. So we have la chaise est au-dessus de la table. La table est au-dessous de la chaise. Au-dessous de la chaise. So, the chair is above the table. The table is below the chair. Of course, these sentences don't actually make a whole lot of sense. There's no reason why a chair would be above a table, but it gives you the general sense if you're talking about a picture being above the couch or what have you. La lampe est sur la table. La table est sous la lampe. So the lamp is on the table and the table is beneath or underneath, beneath the lamp. La chaise est à côté de la lampe. The chair is next to the lamp. We could have switched these two. It doesn't matter really. We could have said la lampe est à côté de la chaise and it doesn't really change anything. La lampe est à gauche de la table et la table est à droite de la lampe. Okay, so the lamp is to the left of the table and the table is to the right of the lamp. La chaise est entre la table et la lampe. So the chair is between the table and the lamp. La lampe est derrière la chaise et la chaise est devant la lampe. So the lamp is behind the chair and the chair is in front of the lamp. La table est au milieu de la salle. So we could just say that the table is in the middle. La table est au milieu. But if we want to be more specific, it's in the middle of the room. La table est au milieu de la salle. Okay, so if you're saying it's in the middle of something, then you want that construction with de. La chaise est en face de la lampe. It's across from the lamp. La chaise est en face de la lampe. All right, I just want to do a quick review about possessive adjectives. It seems to have been something that has been forgotten. So remember, possessive adjectives in English are things like my, your, his and her, our, your, and their. For example, my bed. His poster, okay, their chairs, all right? And we know which one of these to use based on who it belongs to and by the gender and number of the word, okay? So we have mon, ma, mes all mean my, but masculine, feminine, and plural of the word. Okay, ton, ta, te all mean your, informally. Son, sa, se can mean his or her. Okay, and we'll use the masculine or feminine. We'll use the masculine if what is being talked about is a masculine word, and we'll use the feminine if what is being talked about is a feminine word. Okay, for our, we have notre, notre, and no. And for your, either formally or all of your, okay, votre, votre, and vos. For their, leur, leur, and leur with an S. Okay, so let's take a second and we'll just kind of give a few examples so you can see them a little bit better. Okay, so we have a few examples here using some of the vocabulary that was introduced at the beginning of the lesson. So, we have ma lampe est à côté de mon lit. All right. Sa table est devant son canapé. Notre tapis est sous notre fauteuil. Okay, so here I've underlined which words are masculine and which words are feminine. So the feminine words are underlined in red and the masculine words are underlined in blue. Okay, so if we look at the first sentence, ma lampe est à côté de mon lit. Okay, it doesn't matter who is saying this. Lampe has to have the feminine form because lampe is a feminine word. La lampe. Okay. Lit has to have the masculine form because lit is a masculine word. Okay, so even if instead of talking about my, you're talking about your lamp is next to your bed, okay, we would replace ma with ta, still feminine, and we would replace mon with ton. Okay, ta lampe est à côté de ton lit. Right, let's look at the second one. Sa table est devant son canapé. Okay. Now, we don't know if we're talking about a girl or a boy here because remember, son, sa, and se can be used either for il or for elle. What's masculine and what's feminine here are the objects. Okay. So this sentence, without any other context, could translate as either her table is in front of her couch, or his table is in front of his couch, or her table and his couch and his table and her couch. So it's not clear without more context than what we have here, okay? But if instead we were going to talk about, for example, their table and their couch, okay? Table is a feminine word. We're going to use leur. Leur table est devant leur canapé. Okay? We kind of luck out in the last category. These ones here, they don't change in spelling between the masculine and the feminine. So we can just use leur. Okay? And then lastly, we have notre tapis est sous notre fauteuil. Okay? Tapis and fauteuil are both masculine words, and we're talking about our. Our rug is underneath our armchair, okay? So I hope that this is a little bit more clear for you. I wanted to give you a little bit of a review, and this is something that you could see on a quiz coming up. Okay, this is where I'm going to leave you. I'm going to wish you bonne chance, and I will see you next time.